Hello there, friendly neighbors, and welcome back to our channel. Luna hasn't been in one of my videos in a while, and I just wanted to remind you guys that she's alive and well, and she's the most perfect little angel that there ever was. Just in case you guys were wondering. You may notice I'm filming in a different part of my house today. That's literally only because, normally when I do these sort of crafting videos, I'm facing that way. But, my living room's really messy and I just don't feel like cleaning it. Also, now you get a beautiful view of my lovely fish tank. Of course, if you follow me on Instagram, you're very aware of Bonnie and Clyde back here. Clyde, of course, being my beta fish and Bonnie being all the other fish in the tank with him. They're happy little fish. They're just gonna be hanging out in the background there. Today, I wanted to take some time to review a product that I have seen quite a bit online, and I just wanted to see what's up with it, give my opinions on it, and possibly modify it in a few ways that I think that it could be changed. What is this magical product, you might be asking yourself? Well, that, my friends, is the Ferret Bubble Backpack.
Wow.
It seemed like these were really popular in the Ferret Owner community a couple months ago, and then people just like stopped talking about them. I don't know if I've just not seen people talk about them or everyone just forgot they existed. I think the reason that this bag became so popular is that a lot of people want to take their ferrets with them when they go places. Brynn mentioned this in her video about ferret boredom, where she talked about how it's not a bad idea to just take your ferret with you when you're going places to sort of give them something to do, a little bit more enrichment. And yeah, obviously you don't want to be carrying your kennel around. So a product like this is perfect for if you're just running to the corner store and you want to give your ferret a little bit of an adventure. I think it's nice because you get like a full view of your ferrets. To me, it kind of looks like a rocket ship. I wish there were little like wings on the end. So I did just buy this off of Amazon. I think it was like 25 bucks or something. I will have a link down below if any of you guys are curious. I wanted to unbox this on camera because I like a good unboxing, but because it comes from a factory, I had a feeling that it was gonna smell a lot like plastic and I just didn't want to surround my ferrets with that scent. So I actually opened it a couple days ago and I've been letting it kind of air out in my living room ever since then. So the plasticky sort of smell is gone. So sorry guys, you didn't get to see me unbox it. I promise you it really wasn't that riveting. I literally just took it out of a bag and opened it up. This whole little front here fully unzips all the way down and then it opens up sort of like that. There's this little like a firm sort of pad at the bottom and I assume that's just to keep the ferrets comfortable or something, which you know, not that bad. There's also a clip in here to clip your ferret's harness onto. It seems kind of more dangerous to me because if your ferret is clipped by the harness and then they're like struggling to get out of the harness, maybe they'll get themselves caught or something. I'm not gonna be using the clip and I would probably recommend maybe just not using it. So there are three holes down here for air. And then we also have three holes on either side also for air. And then there's also a little mesh part here on the pocket, which you can actually unzip, I believe. Yes, you can unzip it, which I guess is just for like access to the ferrets if you don't want to open the top. And then on the one on this side, it's also mesh, but then it has a little thing to hold your water bottle or something in. I'm not going to be using this. Like, it just seems like that's going to then restrict airflow into the bag. And then the back, you just have like backpack straps, which I just realized aren't attached. The things that I'm really noticing that I don't think are great about this backpack The things I'm noticing aren't great about this backpack right off the bat. Got it. It seems like this is a very easy thing for your ferrets to overheat in. Because there's all this plastic, I imagine if you're gonna go out with your ferret on a sunny day, the sun's gonna be beaming right into here. They gonna get hot and spicy real quickly. So I definitely would not recommend taking this out on a sunny day. I haven't tested it out yet, but I can already tell you just based on knowledge of how heat works. And I'm not really sure that this backpack has enough airflow. Like the holes it has in the side and in the front are pretty big, but I guess that I'm just gonna have to see when I go and try it out. So there are a few modifications that I wanna make to this backpack right away that I know I'm gonna want. The first one being I want a way to be able to know what temperature it is inside of here to know if my ferrets are overheating. So from Amazon, I bought this little hiking thermometer. It was cheap, but it works. I put it under my armpit earlier to make sure it works. So I'm gonna find a way to put this inside. And then another thing that I wanna do to help with temperature is I want to figure out a way to put ice packs inside of here that is safe and comfortable for the ferrets. Because like I said, I think that this is a product that they're definitely gonna overheat in. So I think ice packs are definitely a must. But to start off, I'm gonna start with this little thermometer. Forgot the word for it for a second. I got big brain. I'm gonna start off by doing that. I have my handy dandy needle and my handy dandy case of lots of colors of thread. I'm gonna go with red because I want it to blend into the bag. I didn't bring scissors. I was so ill prepared. There, that seems relatively sturdy. All right, so that's sort of what that looks like. You can see it's kind of dangling. It's definitely off center, but I don't care. Now, we got the ice pack step. What I'm gonna be doing, I'm gonna go get my ice packs first. Step one, let's get the ice packs. So I've got these two small little ice packs that I got at the dollar store. Now I don't wanna like put them directly in because that could be really dangerous. My ferrets are just like stepping on this constantly. So what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna put them inside of one of Alex's socks. Alex has big feet, so his socks are big. So I can fit an ice pack in here very comfortably. And then I don't have to worry about them getting like freezer burn on their feet. So yeah, I'm just gonna throw that bad boy in there and tie it off. I might just stick these like at the side sort of, I guess, so that they're kind of just cooling the air inside of it. And then I also have this blanket that I'm gonna be putting in there just to give them something a little cozy. Let me see how I can put this in here to make it comfortable. That looks kind of cozy. I've got the ice packs on either side here. I can't really think of anything right off the bat that I want to do to change it. You know, the temperature was really my biggest issue with this bag. Obviously, I'm not going to put all five of my ferrets in here. I think that this backpack has a very clear 1 to 2 ferret limit, maybe 3 if they're babies. And even then, that seems like a lot. So we're going to be taking Andromeda and Alara for a walk because they haven't been on my channel enough, guys. They got upstaged by Lyra pretty quick. Here they are, freshly awoken from their nap.
Go, Lyra. Go inside.
And let's put Andromeda in.
Go be my sister. What's this? Where are we?
They're just having a little sniff.
How is it, baby? How is it? Do you feel like you're in a rocket ship?
It kind of looks like you're in a rocket ship.
I can pet you through this hole. What's up, baby? You want to go for a walk? You want to go for a walk?
I mean, they seem pretty chill. So it's only 13 degrees Celsius out right now, which is pretty cool. In Canada, September hits and then winter is just kind of like, hello, friend. So it's already snowed for us actually, just once. So it's kind of the perfect time for me to go test this out. And Lara, I think you're enjoying yourself. They're getting cozy. We're gonna go out and we're gonna test this backpack now that I feel pretty comfortable with them in it. So cut to us doing that.
I'm going on a trek. Oh, this is heavier than I thought it would be.
Thank you.
over there. That's what I came to the conclusion
What'd
of.
What'd you say?
There are some houses over there. So now it's time for the reason that you guys are actually hopefully watching this video, and that is my review of the Ferret Bubble Backpack. Now I'm gonna just do a pros and cons list because I am a big fan of a good old-fashioned pros and cons list. So let's get this started. Starting with the pros. So the first pro is that this product is cute. That's something you really can't deny. The bag is adorable, the aesthetic is great, and I think that it is a big fashion statement, honestly, to be wearing ferrets on your back. The second pro is that it is fun. I had a really good time going out with my ferrets in this bag. I thought it was a really cute little bonding experience for us, and I just really enjoyed myself while I was out there. And now the last pro is that this product is practical. I sort of brushed on this at the beginning of the video when I talked about wanting to bring your ferrets with you when you go outdoors, and obviously a kennel just isn't the best thing to do that with. So a bag like this is super awesome if you want to take your ferret with you when you're going out and maybe they aren't harness trained or you're just not comfortable letting them out on the harness. Now for the cons and what I think make this product not super great. The first one is obviously the one that I've kind of been stuck on this entire video, and that is that this product is really hot. When Alex and I were on our walk, the inside of the bubble backpack got to 25 degrees Celsius, and that's pretty close to the danger zone for ferrets. I ended up unzipping the backpack halfway through the walk, just because it was getting really toasty in there and I was super uncomfortable with it. It is important that I point out, I don't think I did a really good job packing the ice packs. I actually might just either eliminate the blanket that I used or use a super thin blanket, because it just didn't seem like the ice packs had access to the air, so they weren't really cooling anything at all. So maybe just by doing that, I would be able to actually cool it down in there a little bit. The second con to it is that this product is definitely not for everyday use. And what I mean when I say that is that this is something you can definitely only use when it is cool and cloudy outside. I think it's a good product for the Canadian winter, actually, but I'm definitely not going to be busting this bad boy out in the middle of summer. The third con is that this backpack does require modification. I definitely personally would not feel safe bringing this out with my ferrets if I hadn't modified it in the way that I did. At least you really need ice packs, and I do strongly recommend getting a thermometer for it. A digital thermometer would probably be the best, just because then you can have a really accurate reading of what temperature it is, and also then you don't have the dangers of an actual thermometer. The one I used for the video was literally just so that I could do it for this video, and I'm gonna be replacing it with a digital one now that I know that this is a product that I'm probably gonna use again. And the third con is that it has several potential hazards outside of the ones that I already mentioned. The harness clip is one that comes to mind. I just don't think that's a safe feature for the reasons I mentioned earlier. Also, there's the whole problem of the mesh in the bag. That mesh could be dangerous if your ferret gets their nails caught in it, or there's the potential of them tearing it if you aren't paying attention to them. Now, all of that aside, I do want to give this product a score out of 10 just to really summarize my feelings that I have for it. So, the Ferret Bubble Backpack, in my opinion, gets itself a 5.5 out of 10. Sort of a failing mark, not completely there yet though. I don't think that this is a completely terrible product, but I definitely would recommend a mesh cat backpack before I would recommend this one. By using a mesh cat backpack, you would get rid of the main problem I have with this product, and that's just the heat. Having said that, I do think that it's a decently put together product, and it's really cute, and I had a lot of fun with it, like I said. I probably am gonna be using it again just for short trips to the corner store on cold days, but I definitely wouldn't recommend it to someone without giving them all of the cons that I just listed out. I definitely don't have anything against people using this product, but just keep in mind the safety risks that I did mention and just make sure you're doing it safely.
Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, because by doing all of those things, you too can become a citizen of the friendly neighborhood, which is, in my professional opinion, the best place to be. Oh, you wanna go back in? Do you like it in there? You can go back in. If you guys have any other ferret products that you want to see me review or try out and maybe see if I can improve, I actually really liked doing this video, so I think that maybe I'll make a couple more. There are some products that I already have in mind that I kind of wanted to test out because I saw them online, and who knows, maybe they'll be good. So feel free to leave comments, suggestions in the comments section down below. Are you having fun? Maybe we'll walk over to the pet store today, Rara. And go buy you some salmon skin rolls. Have a great rest of your day, guys. I will see you next week where I do something. I don't know. I don't plan that far ahead in my life. Goodbye.
Okay, let's go. I'm still going, I'm going on a trek. Gotta test this bad boy out. One block is not enough. You making dinner tonight, babe? Or is that on me? Okay, I'll be back later.